Hello everyone, welcome to Medit Trainer's Corner. My name is Junie Che, and I am a technical support and product specialist in North America. It is a pleasure to be here with you today. If you have any questions during the lecture, please ask through the live chat, and we will respond in real time. Today in this video, we will be discussing scanning positions, how to properly retract, scanning in mouth, and capturing the occlusion scan. Let's start with scanning positions. There are multiple ways to position yourself when scanning a patient. Users can position themselves from the side, back, or front. Users should find a position that is most comfortable for them. The position in the picture displays the back position. This position allows the operator to scan over the patient's head. Regardless of the position, we recommend users to adjust the height of the dental chair and ensure that the scanning elbow is at a 90-degree angle. If the dental chair is positioned too high, an operator's shoulder may be burdened when scanning. Perform scanning comfortably with the shoulders down at an elbow angle of 90 degrees. Once users find a comfortable position, they will need to properly retract to get accurate scans. Retraction is intended to minimize soft tissue obstruction. With proper retraction, the scanner can get the most accurate intraoral scan data. One way to retract is by making a hook shape with the index finger. Users can retract the cheeks with the index finger and place the scanner on the occlusal surface. Users will have to move the index finger in the same direction the scanner is moving. This will create ample space between the scanning area and the soft tissue. For anterior retraction, make a V shape with the index finger and middle finger to isolate the lips. After retracting, users must scan the anterior units in a zigzag motion around the incisal edges. Operators can also use retraction tools instead of using their fingers. We recommend users to avoid plastic or metal retractors. These materials can cause reflections of the scanner light, which may result in poor scan data quality. Now let's discuss intraoral scanning. Users must retract the soft tissue and place the scanner tip on the occlusal surface area. The unique occlusal anatomy is being used as a starting point with good reference data. Starting a scan from this area will help create a good foundation for the scan. Be sure to press the scan start button only when you have found a good occlusal surface area. If the scanner is activated outside of the mouth, the scanner will scan unnecessary data while entering the patient's mouth. This might result in the software creating unwanted noise, and users may have difficulty following the scan strategy. Please place the scanner on the occlusal surface area before pressing the button to start the scanning process. Now, let's scan. When scanning, it's important to look at the live view window on the bottom right-hand side. You can think of the live view as the camera's field of vision. If the live view shows clean scan data, the scanner will capture the data accurately. If you notice blue noise in the live view window, this indicates that the scanner is too far from the surface area. To avoid this, place the scanner as close as possible to the teeth or adjust the scan depth control. If the view is still unclear, you will need to check the scanner tip for watermarks or visible scratches. Start scanning from the occlusal surface area with distinct geometry and continue to the buccal or lingual surface. As mentioned earlier, users can minimize soft tissue obstruction by retracting and moving the index finger along with the scanning direction. Scan the anterior teeth in a zigzag manner around the incisal edges. The zigzag technique is used to capture the incisal edge, labial surface, and lingual surface in a fluid motion. Following this scan strategy will help users get the most accurate scan data for anterior units. After scanning the occlusal surface area, users must tilt the scanner tip 45 degrees to scan the buccal or lingual side. By tilting the scanner at 45 degrees, users can capture more of the occlusal surface areas along with the gingiva around the buccal or lingual surface. This will help the scanner properly stitch the data between the occlusal surface, buccal or lingual, and the gingiva. When scanning the buccal or lingual side, we recommend having the occlusal surface, buccal or lingual surface and the gingiva at a 1:1:1 ratio. Users can monitor the range through the live view window on the bottom right-hand side. Unwanted soft tissue may still get captured even with retraction. To delete any unnecessary data, users have the smart soft tissue filtering option. This tool is useful because it can automatically filter out the unwanted soft tissue. Depending on the filtering level option, the amount of the captured soft tissue will vary. Here are photos of the same teeth scanned with the three different filtering options. The filtering option on the left is the filtering off option. With this filter, the scanner will capture all the soft tissue, cheek, and tongue if it crosses the scanner's field of view. Since tissue areas are not forcibly removed, this option is useful for scanning edentulous cases and typodonts. The option in the middle allows users to capture only a certain amount of gingiva. This filter removes any soft tissue that interferes with the scan, leaving only the necessary gingiva. With this option, users can scan at a fair speed without soft tissue interruption. This option is suitable for most cases. The option on the right will block the gingiva and scan only the teeth surface area. This filtering option is useful when users need more data for the interproximal and contact areas. An ideal way to use this filter would be to scan the patient with the middle filter first. After obtaining the needed information, users can switch to the last filter to capture additional scans of only the teeth. Users can always scan with the third filter option first. Then scan with the first filter to add soft tissue data. In contrast, users can also scan with the first filter option then additionally scan with the third filter to capture tooth structure data. When scanning a full arch case, users can immediately check if the scan data is reliable by using the reliability map. The reliability map shows how dependable the scan data is by using a color map. Capturing data from only one angle will result in red or dark green data. When users scan from various angles, such as the buccal and lingual surface, the scanned area will turn bright green. The brighter the green, the more reliable the scan data is, and the data can be confidently sent to the laboratory. Red means that the scan data is insufficient and requires additional scanning. An empty hole indicates that the scanner was not angled properly to capture that area. The reliability map can be checked in real time, even during live scanning. Users can use the reliability map to verify desired areas that require additional scanning. Critical areas, such as abutments, margin lines, and contacts, must display the light green color when scanning. Also, when scanning a full arch, it is important to capture the anterior units in light green as well. Once you have completed the maxillary and mandibular full arch scans, you will need to capture the occlusion scan. To make an accurate prosthesis, accurate bite information is required. Let's look at occlusion scanning for a full arch case. Before scanning the occlusion, make sure that there is no soft tissue data floating above the posterior teeth. If unwanted soft tissue data remains on either the mandible or maxilla, it may be difficult to obtain accurate occlusal data. Please use the trimming tool to remove unnecessary soft tissue. For the bite registration, position the scanner inside with the patient's mouth open. If the scanner is positioned while the mouth is closed, it may cause discomfort to the patient. To get accurate occlusion scan data, the scanner tip should be placed on the buccal side of the patient's posterior molar. When the scan starts, users will need to move the scanner up and down in a vertical motion and scan 6 to 8 teeth evenly for both sides. Try to scan only the posterior areas where the occlusion is stable. More accurate occlusal data can be obtained when the occlusion data is aligned with the posterior teeth rather than the anterior teeth. If the patient has missing posterior teeth, the retained teeth should be scanned for the bite registration. Also, scanning the occlusion with the patient sitting upright can guarantee better data compared to scanning with the patient lying down. There are many cases where a clinic may want to only capture a quadrant. Just like a full arch case, approximately 6 to 8 teeth should be scanned up and down in a vertical motion from the posterior molar. If the patient has missing teeth, the retained teeth should be scanned for the bite registration. If there is too much missing tooth data, it is advised to scan the full arch to get the bite. Many users have common questions regarding the occlusal data. Let's look at the two most frequently asked questions together. What should I do if the scan data is not automatically aligned, even though the occlusion was sufficiently scanned? Automatic alignment will generate based on the patient's oral environment and the scanning method of the operator. We also advise users to capture more of the tissue area, since the software is using both the teeth anatomy and gingiva to align the bite. You can also use manual alignment, and reference points can be placed where there is distinct anatomy. The software will take the data and align the bite properly. Does repeating the optimization process improve the accuracy of the scan data? Optimization is the process of reorienting the scan XYZ axis. So if the optimization is already performed, the data will not change if optimization is repeated. For more information on occlusion, please use the Medit Help Center link in the description box below. We want to thank everyone for taking the time to view this broadcast. If you have any questions about today's lecture topic, please leave a question through the live chat window and we will respond in real time. We hope this lesson was helpful today and see you at the next Medit Trainer's Corner lesson. Thank you.